Hey folks, it's Friday afternoon and it's video time. Today we talk about the second session of my networking series, but before we start, I'd like to give you a short introduction about me. My name is Hannes Lagler-Grüner. I'm a multi-cloud architect in one of the biggest consulting companies in Austria. I'm working since 2012 with public cloud, and mainly I'm specialized into Microsoft Asia, and over the time I'm also specializing into other hyperscalers like AWS and GCP. You can find my social footprint on Facebook, Xing, Twitter, LinkedIn. I also have a private blog and for sure my YouTube channel. But enough from me, so let's start with the agenda from today. Today we talk about advanced networking settings in Asia. So my last session was the basic networking configuration. So we take a look into Microsoft virtual networks, security groups, application security groups, routing tables, public IP addresses. And in this session, I will show you how can you use it? How can you implement those components into your architecture? This session is from video type Nugget and from video category 300. So let's take a look to our agenda from today. First of all, I want to show you a VPN gateway. What is an Asia VPN gateway and how should you use it? Then we go one step further, Asia Firewall. Why it's a good idea to use the Asia Firewall instead of network security groups. Then monitoring technologies like Asia Network Watcher. And at the end, NAT gateway and load balancer. Today we have a really compact theory session and a huge technical session in my live demo. So keep in mind, it's a short technical, but a huge demo environment. So, okay, let's start with Asia VPN gateway. You can use Asia VPN gateway to connect your on-premise environment to your Asia environment. So if you want to connect your branch office or your headquarter over an IPsec tunnel, it's based on IPsec tunnel, to the Asia Cloud VPN gateway is the right product for this. There are different SKUs available. Depending on the SKU, you can achieve a performance rate up to 10 gigabit. You can use a single or a multi-site VPN connection. So this means if you have a single internet provider, the connection is to the Asia Cloud over your internet provider for sure. You can use a single connection. If you have multiple internet providers, you can use a multi-site VPN connection. It's an active-passive connection or an active-active connection, depending on your preference. Okay, we have the site-to-site VPN gateway. So let's take a look to the VPN gateways continue. So site-to-site VPN gateway is normally for branch office or headquarter connection. You have the ability, in the current time we are talking about COVID-19, so many customers, many managers, many IT guys are working from home office. So Asia VPN gateway has also the possibility to use point-to-site VPN connections. So this means on my PC, there's a software installed and my PC can directly connect to the public Asia Cloud with a point-to-site VPN connection. Meantime, the point-to-site VPN connection is a really cool solution because it's including Asia AD authentication. So this means you have a separate client called Asia VPN client, and inside the Asia VPN client you can configure, okay, to connect to my Asia environment you have to authenticate over your Asia AD credentials. So this means you're using your username, your password, the same like Office 365. And on top, you can configure Azure Conditional Access Policy, which means when you're coming from outside your network and from an untrusted device, not a company device, not a marked as complete device, you have to use for your authentication username and password, and on top a second factor, a multi-factor authentication like a push notification, SMS, telephone call or whatever. Really cool stuff. You can use this in your environment. And if you have an headquarter and you need a dedicated connection, you can also use ExpressRoute. ExpressRoute is a separate connection. You can you have to configure a BGP configuration. So this is the reason why you have two circuits. You have one circuit for your infrastructure as service connectivity, so into your virtual network, and you have the ability to use the second circuit named Microsoft Peering for your PaaS services, and also if you need it for Office 365. So each traffic to your PaaS services, like a database as a service, like a storage account, if this services are not connected to your internal network. This is a topic from our last network session, this next week. You can use the Microsoft circuit to communicate over that circuit with PaaS services, with the public IP address. And the reason why this is possible, you learn the public IP addresses from your data center. You can add and filter to your ExpressRoute circuit. You learn over PGP all public IP addresses, and your firewall knows, okay, when I'm talking about talking with the public IP address XYZ, I have to route the traffic is routed over the Microsoft peering from the ExpressRoute circuit. Yes, this is ExpressRoute. ExpressRoute normally is based on two bills. So one bill you get from Microsoft for the ExpressRoute gateway, and the second bill you get from your provider. There are some providers available in Austria, Austrian or worldwide, which are supporting ExpressRoute connection to the public Azure cloud. So take a look to the portal from Microsoft, all vendors are available. Okay, enough about connectivity connections. We will see a VPN connections later on in my demo. Let's go ahead and talk about via firewall. So in the last session, the first session, I showed you network security groups. Network security groups are layer 3, layer 4 based access control list. And an Azure firewall is a layer 7 security firewall, a next generation firewall. There are two versions available. If you're using the standard version, you don't have the ability to use the premium features like TLS expansion, IDPS or URL filtering. So these are services from the premium firewall, and today in my demo I will show you the premium firewall. It's a stateful firewall as a service, so you don't have to think about, okay, how many servers is the traffic, are there too many traffic, should I upgrade or downgrade the firewall? It's a PaaS service for you. So you use the firewall, you use the configuration, you configure the firewall, but everything at the back end is Microsoft. Microsoft checks, okay, is the firewall working? Is this higher available? Are enough resources available? And so on. It's a higher available firewall. It's an unrestricted cloud scalability. Yeah, that's okay. And there's a central administration over policy manager available. So we have a really, really cool policy manager to configure your settings. For example, port settings from your backend to your frontend, from your frontend to your backend, over the whole network, TLS inspection, IDPS, URL filtering, and so on. There is a central administration available for all your firewall products in Asia. That's a cool stuff. Okay, let's go one step further. Network Watcher. So we have a network environment. We need a monitoring tool. Network Watcher is the tool what you can use. It's a central network management tool. It allows you to monitor your environment, to diagnose, to get metrics and logging. You have the ability too for your end-to-end monitoring check, so you can monitor your environment inside the cloud, and you can also monitor your connectivity about over express route or side-to-side VPN. So you have the ability to check your connectivity to on-premise. Cool stuff. Next, you can take a look to your network topology. So there's a separate option available. I will show this in my demo later on. You have the ability to diagnose your network traffic. So if there is an error, if there are some packages lost, you have the packaging capturing feature for VMs. You can take a look to IP flows. Are there some network security groups which are blocking your connectivity from your server to your backend, for example? So all features are in one place, and this is Network Watcher. When we think about, or when we talk about connectivity from inside to the internet inside the Asia cloud, we have the ability to assign a public IP address. We have the ability to assign a local lancer, and now we have the ability to implement a net gateway too. So this net gateway give you the ability for outbound connection only. So you can route your traffic when your client is communicating with other services from third-party vendors, for example. You can define, okay, this is my net gateway, and this net gateway have a static IP address. Not a few years ago, so you have a dynamic IP address, you communicate with services from other providers, and it's always very heavy to set a static IP address in your allowed rules. This IP address can communicate with my API service, so it's a little bit tricky few years ago. And now you have the ability to use a net gateway with a static IP address. Each communication from this subnet, you bind a net gateway to your subnet, so you can say, okay, from a backend subnet, I will communicate with a third-party API, and I have a static, dedicated IP address for that communication. It's fully managed from Microsoft, also PaaS service, and it's highly resilient. And here you can see once more, you can connect over local lancer, a public IP address directly signed to your VM. Not the best solution from my point of view. And you have the ability right now, the net gateway. And at the end, I want to show you the Lopalancer feature. So we have different Lopalancer types. It's a layer 4 Lopalancer. You have the ability to use an internal Lopalancer and an external Lopalancer. So keep in mind, when you have as a default three-tier application, you have your front-end, for example, you have your middle tier, and you have your back-end tier. The front-end is available from the internet, for example. You can use to achieve this your public Lopalancer. And from the back-end perspective, you don't need a public Lopalancer because the backend is only available from the front end. You can use for this tier an internal Lopalancer. So the Lopalancer get a private IP address, and your public, first level tier or the internet facing tier is communicating over the Lopalancer private IP with the middle tier, and the middle tier is communicating over the Lopalancer private IP with the backend tier. There are also two types available about Lopalancing types. So You have the option to use a regional load balancer. This means you have, for example, your data center West Europe. Data center West Europe means it's an availability zone. So this is not physically one data center. It's up to three data center or more. I guess in West Europe it's seven right now. And you can use this, the three load balancer, the three data center in an availability zone. So there is the possibility to use a standard or a global load balancer, which means, okay, the load balancer is available in three availability zones inside your data center in West Europe, for example. And if you want a worldwide load balancer and global load balancer, which is not specified into a data center, you can use for web application firewall Asia Frontdoor, and for load balancing technology layer 4 traffic manager. Okay, load balancer are available in two types, in standard and basic type. The standard load balancer is trusted, has a zero trust network model per default. So it's secure by default. So not each traffic is allowed over the load balancer. You have to configure a network security group. And the basic and the cheaper one load balancer is open to the internet per default. So each port is open. You have to configure your backend and that's it. Okay, we are now done with our theory session, 16, 17 minutes. So let's go one step further about our demo. We have today, we have a huge demo with three scenarios. The first scenario, we are using the components from the first session, from the basic session. We have the scenario one, we have an application inside Asia. We have a front-end and a back-end, a two-tier application with an IIS web application, and at the back-end an SQL database. And the first scenario, we add a public IP address to the front-end environment and define network security groups and application security groups to communicate from the front-end to the back-end and from the internet to the front-end. So this is our first scenario, what we can use to publish an application, two-tier application to the to the internet. The second scenario, so we have now, in the scenario one, we have a single VM in the front end and a single VM in the back end. And the second scenario is to add more VMs in the front end and maybe also in the back end, and load balance the traffic over an Asia load balancer. This is our second scenario. And the third scenario is we don't use network security groups and application security groups. We're using Asia Firewall instead. So we have a DNet configuration to publish the application to the internet and define the routing tables. We have configured in the first session, in the basic session, routing tables, and to use and to configure and to define routing tables and bind routing tables to our virtual network to transfer each traffic over the Asia firewall. Okay, we are now in my demo environment. So let's take a look. So we have three resource group available. We have the networking advanced security group, the network basic from the last session, and the networking clients network security group. So let's take a look to my basic network security group. So in my last session, we've configured this stuff. So we configured two network virtual networks. I removed the East US services. So we have one virtual network. We have two network security group, one for the backend, one for the frontend. We have a routing table for our West Europe services. We have two application security group, one for the backend, one for the frontend. What I've done is I've implemented a private DNS zone. The reason for that is I'm using an application The application is a front-end application, a back-end application. The front-end is communicating with the back-end. This is a Microsoft SQL Server. And then the communication is not over the IP address, it's over a DNS entry. So demo.ecfirewall.net is my DNS entry. And I have one e-record inside the private DNS zone named SQL. And this is the IP address. So this is my backend IP address from my SQL server. So let's take a look to the networking clients. I have here two VMs, one VM in the front end and one VM in the backend. This is my SQL server. So we have to start those VMs. So stopped right now. The VM have no public IP address, is only a private IP address available. So the private IP address from the front end is 11.0.0.4 and it's bind to my front end subnet. So we can take a look here to the network interface, and inside the network interface we can see on which subnet which subnet the network interface is bound. So demo basic West Europe in the front end subnet, and we have a second VM called demo VM SQL, and we also have to start this VM, and we can see here in the overview from the VM also demo basic West Europe in the backend subnet. So we have two different subnets configured in our last session inside the virtual network, once for the front end and one subnet for the backend. Perfect. And this is the IP address for the backend SQL server 11.0.1.5, and also available over the public at the private DNS zone sql.acfirewall.net. Okay. We also have a key vault in place, because the communication between front end and backend is a SQL communication, and the connection string itself, it's not inside the web config. So this is the baddest idea. So I've configured a separate secret inside Asia Key Vault, and this includes the demo, my connection string, my SQL connection string. You can see it here. This is my SQL connection string for the server sql.demo.ecfirewall.net with the username, the password too. Okay, so let's go one step further and switch to my advanced network, advanced security group. I have a storage account here in place. The reason for that is for the network watcher. We will see it later on. So let's start. I want to create a public IP address first for my front-end environment. So go to the marketplace, select public IP, click on create, and give the public IP a name. So in this case, I'm using the default settings, IP44, it's okay for me. Standard SKU is also okay. A regional, so it's based into one data center. Global means I can switch over different data center in West Europe, for example. I give the IP address a DNS label, should be available, perfect. Select the subscription resource group, the location, and no zone. In this case, perfect. So it takes some seconds to provision the IP address. I switch back to my resource group and to the resource group for my clients, because I want to add this public IP address, or want to assign this public IP address to the network interface from my VM. I'll show you now the longest way to get the network configuration. There's a much shorter available, but for understanding, it's the longest way is the perfect one. So we are going to the VM. On the left side, you can see a networking section. Inside the networking section, you see, okay, how many network interfaces are assigned to my VM. Asia VMs can have more than one network interface assigned depending on the VM size. In this case, I have only one, it's okay for me. So I have here my first network interface, my primary network interface. I click on this network interface, and on the left side you see I'm switching now to the network interface service. It's a separate service, this is the fastest way. On the left, the right upper side, I see the public, the private IP address, I'm sorry, not the public, and the VM don't have a public IP address assigned. On the left side, you can see IP configurations. And inside the IP configuration, you see, okay, I have a dynamic private IP address, but no public IP address. I click on this network configuration. And here I can see there's a public IP address assignment associate available, associate an existing one. You can create a new IP address from here, but I've created a public IP address for this solution, and I'm using the public IP address. Click on save. Will take some seconds, and when it's finished, I can communicate over the internet with my application environment. You will see it in a few seconds. Yes, it's okay for me. So later on, we have assigned a public IP address to our VM, in the front-end subnet. But we have a problem right now. When we take a look to, or when we try to access to this VM, it's not working right now. Why? Because we don't have any network security rules or networking rules in place to allow this traffic. Okay, the assignment now is complete. So let's take a look to our VM. So we have now here the ability to get the VM configuration from the overview perspective. And on the right side, you can see the public IP address and the DNS name, which is assigned to my VM. I want to try now to connect to the VM, and it's not working. Why it's not working? Because we don't have any network security rules or networking rules in place. So the connection from your public IP address to the private IP address, or from the internet to the private IP address, is not allowed right now. And this is the reason why we have to configure in the first scenario also the networking security group. So let's go ahead and take a look to our networking settings once more, because I want to use the application security groups, not dedicated IP addresses. I want to add those VMs, those tiers into network net application security groups. And it's really simple. You can see here on the networking interface, you have the ability to see the inbound port rules, the outbound port rules, and also the application security groups. And here I can assign my front-end VM once or more into application security groups, which are configured in our basic session. So let's take a look to the configuration. We have here the front-end VM, and what we want to assign the front-end VM to our application security group for front-end. Click on save. Take some time. Okay, we have now our SQL VM. So keep in mind, we don't need a public IP address assigned to this VM, because it's only accessible over the front-end IP from the front-end private IP. So we are going to the networking section, select application security groups, and assign the back-end application security group to our backend VM. Okay, it's now in place. So let's take a look to our networking configuration stuff. So let's go to the basic resource group. We have configured in our last session two network security groups. One network security group for the front end and one for the back end. So let's start with the network security group for the front end. So we have our front end tier. This is our web application server, and we have to give to the ability to add to access to the VM over the internet over port 80. So we are going to the input security rules and click here on add and select a new rule or assign a new rule. Source is any, source port is also, any destination is an application security group. Here I can add now my frontend application security group because I want to access to the frontend and use a service named HTTP. I can also select a custom service and assign the port 80, but now it's available like a service. I select here, okay, allow action. Priority is 110 and port 80 underscore allow. I click on add. Perfect. We have our network security group for the front-end environment in place. But what we have to do is we have to assign this network security group to our subnet. So let's go here to the subnet area, click on associate, and select our virtual network from our demo environment, also the frontend subnet, and click on OK. Okay, after a few seconds, the assignment was completed, and we have the ability to access to our application from the internet. It takes some seconds. In a few seconds, we try it once more. But now the connection between frontend and backend is any, so you can use each port. And this is the reason why we have a backend network security group also in place. And in this network security group, we are going to the inbound security rules. Click on add, select here the source is not any, so we want to give the application security group frontend the permission to access the source port is okay, the destination is also the application security group to my backend. And here I want to give the application security group frontend the possibility to access to the Microsoft SQL Server port 1433, the ability to connect. So I also select here the priority 110. Give here a good name, so 1433, allow, and click on add. So now the access port from the frontend, source's frontend to the backend is allowed. So let's go ahead and refresh here the website. We should see the web application in a few seconds is available to our environment. To us over the internet. So it's now available. Our website is accessible from the internet. So you can see it's an demo environment from my Global Asia, Virtual Asia session from last year. You can see here on the top, okay, I'm connecting to the Asia Key Vault because I want to get the connection string for my database connection. The database is SQL demo easyfirewall.net with the private IP address 11.0.1.5 with a connection state of success. And I have two entries inside my SQL table, and the first entry is okay. I don't have any error, nothing. But the frontend once more is communicating with the backend and have the ability to use each port. So no restrictions are here in place, and the restrictions are inside this network security group. So we have to add a second rule here once more. And the second rule is any, and here also star. Each other traffic is denied, and we're using the highest priority for 2069 26 and Okay, this is the last rule, all rules. So we are priority based. So we have a priority based setting here. So the 110 is the first rule. Allow the traffic from the front end to the subnet, to the backend subnet over port 1433. And the last configuration is deny everything to our backend subnet. So we have to assign this network security group to our environment. So let's take here the virtual network and also the backend subnet. Click on OK, and the assignment will take up to 20 seconds if everything is in place. So let's take a look after 20 seconds if everything is working fine. Okay, the assignment is now complete. So let's take a look to our VMs. So I have here my two VMs. I have one VM for my frontend. This is this one here. Let's take a look to the network settings for this VM. So here we have the networking part. Let's take a look. So we have one port open. Port is 3389, this is the old configuration from my public IP address, and also port 80 allow from any to my destination frontend. And the same we have in place for our SQL environment. So we have here port 1433 allow only for the frontend to the backend and deny everything else to my VM. When I refresh my website here, everything is working fine and we have a secure environment. But my secure environment, and this is the second scenario, is only available over a single VM. So my second scenario is implementing a load balancer configuration in front of my frontend VM. So let's go ahead and switch to my advanced network security group, resource group, go to the marketplace and search for load balancer. So here we want to use an Asia load balancer. We have here our load balancer. So give the load balancer a name. So I have here my name, select the right region, select the type, internal or public. We want to use a public load balancer because this load balancer is accessible over the internet. It's from SKU standard. It's okay for me. It's a regional, so only in one data center available. I want to create a new public IP address and I want to add the name public VM scenario 2. I want to use availability zone, public IP address v6, I don't need this. So click on create. This setup creates two services for me. The first service is the load balancer itself. And the second service is the public IP address. So I get a new public IP address, which is assigned to the load balancer. It's a really fast deployment. You can see here on the deployment details, the public IP address and the load balancer. So let's take a look to our resource group. Take some time. Come on. So now you can see I have a load balancer service and also a public IP address, a second one. This is my public IP scenario 2. Okay, the load balancer is now in place and now we have to configure the load balancer. But before we start, I want to add a DNS name to my public IP address. So per default, you don't have a public DNS name. I want to add the public IP VM scenario 2 IP address, DNS name, to my load balancer, to my public IP address from the load balancer. Okay, perfect. So now let's go ahead and configure the load balancer itself. We have a frontend IP. We have a frontend IP assigned to our load balancer. This is the public IP scenario 2 load balancer with this public IP address. Now we have to configure a backend pool because we want to route the traffic from the load balancer to my internal frontend environment. So click here on add, select the name, define a virtual network. It's bound to my demo basic network. I want to assign a network interface. In this case, I want to assign a VM, one VM, or maybe in the near future, two or more VMs. So select here my frontend VM, click on add, and add the configuration. The second part is I want to add a health probe. So we have now a backend pool configured. We need a health probe because the load balancer itself have to check, is there a VM available? If it's not available, the traffic will be routed, if it's in place, the traffic to the second VM with a right configuration, with a good health probe. So go ahead, click here on health probes, select the name and leave everything configured as it is. So we have a TCP probe, we have a IIS installed on the VM, so we have to check port 80 with an interval of 5 seconds and with an unhealthy thresholds after two consecutive failures. So this mean 10 seconds. So, okay, click on add. Now we have the backend pool in place and we have the health probe in place, but we have to configure a load balancing rule and bind this rule to our public IP address because we want to publish those settings to our load balancer. So let's go ahead and click on load balancing rules, click here on add and select a name. The name here is Demo VM. I'm using the frontend IP. I only have assigned one frontend IP, load balancer frontend. I have a port 80 in the front, a port 80 in the background. I have a backend pool with one VM configured. I have a health probe. I don't need session persistence. If you have an application which is needing this feature, you can enable it on client or client and protocol. And we have idle timeout and everything is okay. So, okay, the configuration should be in place in a few seconds. Okay, now it's in place. So let's take a look to our website. The website should work over the private IP address, the assigned public IP directly to the VM. So this is my scenario one. And my scenario 2 is, I hope I have the right name, scenario 2. This is my connectivity over the load balancer with the probe settings to my backend. So this is the same website, this is the same VM, but the connection is over a public load balancer. Okay. Great, we have now our environment in place, our second scenario also in place. So let's go ahead and configure scenario 3 with an Azure firewall. Go ahead and switch to our basic resource group. Inside the basic resource group, we deploy an Azure firewall. The reason why I deploy this inside the basic resource group is it's a prerequisite. So let's go to the marketplace, select the Azure firewall or search for the Azure firewall. On the right side, you see the firewall object or the firewall service from Microsoft, click on Firewall, click on Create, and fill out the wizard settings with a firewall name, with a firewall tier. So first of all, the subscription, the resource group, okay, it's perfect. The firewall name, the right region, so our region is West Europe. Availability zone, I leave this as it is. Firewall tier, I want to provision a premium firewall. I want to create a new firewall policy. So in this case, I want to create a new one. Also in West Europe. From premium tier, it's perfect. Choose an exist VM. So select my basic VM, and inside my basic VM, I've configured a firewall subnet. So this is the name is Asia Firewall Subnet. I will show you this later on. I want to add a new public IP address because we will have to assign a public IP address to our firewall because we want to achieve, we want to add the website to the firewall too, over the firewall, over nothing interface. So let's click on next and click on create. Okay, this will take some time. Meantime, I want to show you the configuration inside my subnet. Okay, let's switch back to the network basic security group, resource group. Go to my virtual network in West Europe. Here's my resource group. Inside the resource group, you can find my, you can see my virtual network from West Europe. And inside the virtual network, I have a subnet named Asia Firewall Subnet. This is a requirement for the Asia Firewall. So if you deploy an Asia Firewall and you select your virtual network, you get the information, okay, you have to add Asia Firewall Subnet to provision a new firewall. Okay, so let's wait until the configuration is finished. Take some time. And then go ahead. Yeah, the deployment is complete. We can see here we have three services. One service is the Asia Firewall itself. The second service is the Asia Firewall policy. And the third service is the public IP address assigned to the Asia Firewall. So let's go ahead and go back to our resource group. Inside the resource group, you can also see the three services. The first thing what I have to do is I want to enable, or I have to enable, the logging settings for my firewall. So here's my firewall on the left side. Click on diagnostic settings. And inside this diagnostic settings, you can configure a new diagnostic setting. And I want to add the whole logs and also the metrics. I define here name, and I want to add those information into a log analytics workspace and have a pre-configured log analytics workspace. You can also save it for long-term retention to an Asia storage account, or if you want this information inside your on-premise CM system, for example, you can send those information into an event hub, and you can connect your CM system or your connector from on-premise to the event hub and get the whole informations inside your system. Okay, I click to enable to update the settings. Perfect. So let's go ahead and go to the firewall manager. I have here my firewall manager and visit my firewall itself. The first thing what I want to do is I want to configure my firewall policies. I want to publish my configuration from my web application over the firewall to the public internet. So go ahead and click on DNet rules because I want the netting configuration. I create a new before I start with the configuration, I have to configure collection rules, collection groups. So here you have you don't have the ability to create collection rules. You can configure the default collection rules or based on the default collection rule group. And I want to show you how you can configure your own collection groups. Open your Azure Cloud Shell and execute a separate AC command to create a new collection group. I will share those commands inside my GitHub account so you can use it for your own configuration. So we are now in our environment. So paste the configuration or the script itself or the command itself, EC network firewall policy rule group, collection group, create, minus 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 name, default call group, minus policy name, AC, FV, DIM01, this is our policy name, priority 200, and resource group, everything is okay. So let's start this execution. It takes some time. Okay, it's now finished. You can see here the output, everything is finished. I want to create a second one. Click here, our web application. Okay, I know why this happened. I have the same priority, it's not a good idea. So select 300 and the collection rule will be created. Okay, the second collection rule is also in place, so we can close the Cloud Shell. Okay, you can see now we have here two collection rules available after we are finished with the execution. One is with priority 300 and the second one is priority 200. So let's go ahead and click here on DNAT rules. We have to create an DNAT collection rule. So the first thing what I have to do is I connect a DNAT collection rule for my web application. Select the name, select priority 100, for example, and select the collection group. In this case, I want to use my web app collection rule. Define three rules. The first rule is for RDP frontend. The source IP address is any. It's not a good idea, but it's okay for me right now. The destination protocol is TCP and UDP. The destination port is 3387 because I want to connect over my firewall to my backend over RDP. The destination IP address is the IP address from my firewall, the private IP address from my firewall where I can find this IP address. For this, I open a second tab and go to my firewall settings. So I have here my resource group. Inside my basic resource group, I select my Azure firewall, and on the Azure firewall overview setting, you can find the private IP address from your the public IP address from your firewall. So in this case, this is my public IP, which is assigned. I click on my public IP address, and here you can see, okay, this is my public IP. I select, I add this public IP address here. I want to translate the traffic to my backend. In this case, this is my frontend. And the destination port is 3389. Okay, perfect. We have now our RDP connection to our frontend over our firewall in place. So now we want to add backend, same from any TCP and UDP. B386, same IP address here, not this one here, I'm sorry. So the same IP address, 20.5.5.1.4.3.2, and now to my backend environment, 11.0.1.5, and the destination port is also 3389. Okay, and let's go ahead and add my HTTP port. Also change the name here, it's not correct. From anywhere over TCP. Destination port is 80, destination address is 25.143.62. My destination IP, my translation IP address is the frontend IP, 11.0.0.4, and the destination port is port 80. Okay, we have the rule collection in place. We have two RDP rules for our frontend and for our backend environment, and the HTTP rule also for our frontend environment. So let's click on add, and this will take some time to configure the firewall and those rules. Yeah. Our configuration is now in place, so we can see here all rules based on our rule collection group, web app call group with priority 300. So let's go to the collection groups here. You can see, okay, now I have a DNET collection rule group also assigned with priority 100, and the collection group is priority 300. Okay. Now we should communicate with our application over our firewall. So let's take a look, copy our IP address, our public IP address from our firewall, open another tab, HTTP, public IP, and bam, we are now connected. We have three connection types, one directly connected over the private IP, the second one connected over a load balancer, layer 4 load balancer, and the third over our public firewall IP. Perfect. We are in place. We have now three scenarios, and I want to show you another scenario too. So we have now our firewall for our application publishing. So this is a web application firewall, but we want to use our firewall also for the internal networking stuff. So we don't want to use our network security group to limit the traffic between frontend and backend VMs. We want to use the Azure firewall to do this stuff. So let's go back to our configuration settings, and to achieve this, we have to create networking rules first. So click here, create a networking rule collection, and define here a rule collection named default for our default settings. This is a networking connection. This is also from priority 100. This is our default. Each subnet should have the same configuration. So we select here our default collection group for the default settings, and I want to enable port, also the SMP configuration for the internal network. This I want to use source star destination, or I want to only allow the communication or the connection from your the SMP traffic from the front-end subnet to the back-end subnet. That's a good idea. Okay, perfect. 11.0.0.0/24. This is my subnet from a front-end. Destination port is any. I'm sorry, it's any. So the protocol is ICMP. The destination type is any. In this case, the front-end subnet can ping the port, the VMs from the backend subnet. This should work. And the second one is I want to allow RDP for all of my subnets, So source IP address is star, destination IP address is TCP and UDP is the protocol, because RDP is using both. The destination IP address is 11.0.0.0/16. So this is my whole network. I'm sorry, not the port, so this is 3389. And the destination IP addresses are my whole subnet, my whole address space inside my virtual network. So I'm creating this rule, and this takes some time. Okay, the networking rule collection is now in place. You can see ICMP is allowed and RDP is from anywhere to my whole network allowed. So before we assign the before we create or configure the routing tables, I want to test my RDP connection to my frontend and also to my subnet. To use this, to check this, I want to execute MSTSC and connect to the public IP address. And first of all, I want to connect to my frontend IP. So I have my public IP address from my firewall, and I want to connect to my frontend, and I'm using the port 3387. So I have here the authentication request, add my username. Click on connect, and I'm connected. A few seconds later, I'm connected to my frontend VM. So you can see here, I open the Google Chrome Explorer and access to the HTTP localhost, and this is my web server. Localhost. You can see, perfect, I'm now connected to my web server. So next, I'm trying to ping my backend, ICMP, ping 11.0.1.5-t. It's not possible right now. I hope I have the right IP address. Yes, it's the right IP address. I can also ping, the DNS name. So let's check the DNS name to do this. I have here my SQL, my DNS name. So copy this one here, ping SQL minus dot. Okay, it's not possible to ping now because my network security group is not allowing any ICMP connections, only allowing, I'm trying to telnet 1433, this should be allowed. Yes, it's allowed by network security group. Each other traffic is not allowed over our network security group. But we want to implement the Asia firewall instead of the network security groups. Sorry for that. Okay, let's ping it. So let's go ahead. We have now our firewall in place. We have our DNet configured for our web application. This is our web application. And now we want to go ahead and assign this firewall to our internal network over routing tables. So to do this, go to our resource group network basic. Resource group network basic, and inside the network basic resource group, we have our route table from our basic session last week. So, okay, now we have to configure custom routes. So we have three routes available in Asia. The first route is with the lowest priority is the system defined route. So this is the default routing from the Microsoft. So you can cannot change those routes. The second one is BGP. BGP routing is normally used for virtual WAN, for express route, or for BGP configuration inside site-to-site VPN. This is a second priority, and the highest priority are user-defined routing. So this is the route tables, they have the highest priority. So in this case, I want to create two new routes. The first route I want to define here, default network route. The address prefix is my internal network, so 11.0.0.0/16, and I want to send those traffic to an application, a virtual appliance. And the virtual appliance is my firewall. And now I want to have to add here the private IP address from my firewall. And you see it some steps further. So I'm going to my firewall. And on the right side from my firewall service, you can see, okay, I have here a private IP address. And this is the private IP address from my firewall. Let's copy this IP address, paste it here, and click on OK. This is my first rule, what I want to add. I want to add a second rule too, because each other traffic, for example, to the internet, should also route over my firewall. So let's go ahead and define internet route, for example, and this is all other traffic, 0.0.0.0/0, and it's also routed over an application, virtual appliance, and this is my IP address. Okay, we have now our route table in place. The second step what we have to do is we have to assign a route table to our subnets. But before I show you how you can do this, I want to show you inside Asia. First of all, I want to remove, I have to remove the last rule that ICMP, that blocks ICMP. So go ahead and go to the backend network security group and remove the second rule to drop any traffic. So remove it, take some time, and after some seconds, it should be able to ping the backend. So we are now able to ping the backend because the rule is now removed from our network security group. And what I want to show you is when I do a trace route, to our, let's take it this way. I have a direct link. So there's nothing between my frontend and my backend environment. It's a direct connection. So now I'm adding, I'm assigning the root table to my subnets. So here I want to associate the root table to my backend VNet, to my basic VNet in West Europe, and to my backend subnet, and also to my frontend subnet. Same step once more, to my frontend. When I add or execute a trace route, you can see, okay, I'm not directly connect to my VM. I'm connecting over 11.0.2.7. So this is one of the IP address from the backend, from the firewall backend. And I also have the ability to connect to my backend environment because I've allowed port 3389 from all subnets. Okay, so we are in place. Cool. So let's take a look to our application. Oh, something is wrong. What happens here? Cannot get security credentials. So the web application itself, the web server is available over the internet, but I'm not able to get from the web application server the connection string from the Asia key vault. It's clear because each traffic is routed over the Asia firewall and also the internet traffic, and we don't have any firewall rules in place to allow those traffic. I can see it also here inside my logging. So let's go back to my firewall. I have here my firewall object. I'm sorry, it's not perfect. So I have here my firewall object. And in the beginning, we've enabled the diagnostic settings for our firewall here. And each communication between frontend, backend, between internet to frontend and so on is going over the firewall. And we have logs, diagnostic settings configured to route each logs to our log analytics workspace. And here you have the option, the ability to use Azure Log Analytics. So switch to Log Analytics, select the default query so you can write your own queries. I'm selecting the default queries. Here are the firewall logs. And here you have network rule log data. Click on run. And here you can see everything what's going on inside your network. And you can see, okay, I have a request from my public IP address to my DNet to 10.0.0.4 on port 80, and it's allowed. So it's working. And when we take a look to some deny settings, so we can filter here on action, can say, okay, I want to see all deny actions. And here you can see 11.0.1.5, 123 is not allowed. So we have here your deny action. It's not in real time, so it takes some time that the informations are in that logging area, but it's a cool solution to get an overview about your environment. Okay, so let's go ahead and try to fix the problem for our web application. Okay, so let's go back to our firewall. Go to the resource group, basic. Select the firewall policy manager. Inside the policy manager, I have to create another network rule. And I want to create a new network rule collection for our web application. So this is only for our web application. So web app 01, it's from type network, it's from priority, for example, 601. Collection rule action is allow, and I want to add the collection rule group to my collection rule web app call group, and I want to add three rules. So take a look to SQL acknowledge as I allow to backend. This is my first rule. So source IP address is 11.0.0.4. This is my frontend IP. The protocol is TCP. The destination port is 1433 for SQL Server. And the destination IP address is 11.0.1.5. And the second rule, it's a special rule, because now we have, when we take a look to our website, we have no connection string. So we need a rule to allow the communication between your web app and the Azure keyboard. And the Azure keyboard is a public service in my configuration. So we have to enable the communication between your private IP address from your VM to the public IP address from Azure keyboard. Okay, it's really simple in Azure, in this Azure firewall. So key vault acknowledge allow front end. The source IP address is 11.0.0.4 for my front end. The protocol is TCP. The destination port is 80443 for keyboard. And the destination type is not a IP address, it's a service tag. And inside the service tag, I have the ability to select key vault. I can enable the connection to all key vault settings around the world, around the globe. But in my case, I want to allow the connection only to the West Europe key vault. Okay, perfect. And at the end, I have to enable allow HTTP from the internal network to from any to TCP port 80. So I want to give the ability to connect from the internal network also to my web application. Okay, I'm now in place. I have three rules and I want to add those rules. Okay, our rules are now in place. So let's take a look to our website once more. I've refreshed it. So refresh it once more and you can see I'm able to connect to the key vault, get the connection string successful, connect to the database and get the two entries and display the first entry. Okay, we are now finished with our longer demo. I hope you enjoy it. It's not so easy, so there are some critical steps inside it, but I'm giving my best and everything is working. So I hope you enjoy the session. Give me a feedback and see you next week with the third session from my networking area. See you soon. Goodbye.